Yo, what's poppin', people? Welcome back to another video. Listen, man, we got a banger today. We got a really good video. Something different, and man, let me tell you, it's one of the spiciest videos that we've ever made here on Kicking Their Bass TV. We got the world's hottest chip right here. We got three of them. It was me, my boy Brad, and his roommate Garrett. We went out on the river, and we did a little spicy chip challenge later on in the video. And let me tell you, man, if anybody knows Noah, any of my personal friends, everybody knows I love spicy food. I'm talking like as spicy as it gets. But let me tell you, this chip was the hottest thing I have ever had. I'm not gonna lie, it was bad. Not just because of the burn in my mouth, but our stomachs afterwards, it was horrible. It was so bad that we had to just leave the lake. We couldn't even stay on the lake anymore. We had to find a bathroom immediately. But if you guys aren't new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell. Also, hit the like button if you guys have been enjoying the content. Let me show you guys exactly what these chips are about.
So the Pocky One Chip Challenge, right here, we have three of them. I'm actually filming this intro backwards because I'm telling you, I was in a lot of pain. So this is the bag that the chip comes in. It's individually packaged. The chip is actually very stale, and it's like a black chip, which you guys will see later on in the video. It shows like all the different chip flavors that they had. Oh, this is what I wanted to see. Hold up, right here. Right here. So on the package itself, it says round one, a spicy punch to the tongue. Round two, a fiery jab to the face. Round three, impaired vision from tears. Round four, a low blow to the gut. That was an understatement. And round five, knockout. That's pretty accurate, not gonna lie.
As bad as I know you guys want to see me and intern Brad cry, you guys still need to go watch the full video, the full river day. It was a lot of fun. Caught a bunch of decent old fish, and it was a good time on the big boat, the big rig right here. But let's go ahead and hop into it. Make sure you watch it all the way through. This is a banger, boys. If you guys want to see some more spicy challenges on the channel, drop some comments down below. Let me know what you guys want to see, or any challenges at all. Let us know down below. Let's hop right into it. It's going to be a good one. Let's get it.
I'm so excited to film on the boat.
Yeah?
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, they're trying to tie that new if, do you know it?
This is not good.
I gotta get warmed up. I can catch fish if I cast bad, but I won't wax her. I wanna put ass whooping on them, you know.
Bro, got it? There we go.
Chatterbait.
I want a chatter dong?
Chatter dong, he ain't big, but listen, man, he's something. Sure. Yeah.
Look at that, guys. That guy. Just look at that sauce.
Nothing to brag about, but guess what? Like I always say, get the monkey off your back. First fish today, pretty little guy. Chatter dunk. What I'm throwing, let me show you guys exactly. Let's put him back in. Actually, look.
Look at this.
All right. There we go.
All right, so let me show you guys what I'm throwing. So I'm throwing a white and chartreuse chatterbait, 3/8 ounce. And I got one of these divine swim baits on here. And I was just talking to Bradley. Out here on the river, there's a lot of smaller fish. There's also some really big fish. But I think this is gonna be a key to our success. So this is one of the smaller Divine Swim Baits by 6 Cents. If you wanna get a discount, I'll pop it up on the screen. This is the 3.2 Platinum White. And this thing on the back of the chatterbait, let me show you. It's got a smaller profile. Like if I was pond fishing, or if I was anywhere else, I'd throw a bigger swim bait. But this one's actually messed up here.
Gotta redo it?
Yeah.
Can you show them how to rig it up?
Yeah, sure. Grab one of these real quick.
Push it through the head. Okay. Go up a little bit, break through.
How far do you go up?
You know, that's probably one of the hardest things to ever explain.
You're probably the same way.
I am. It's really like hard. It's
like memory.
Because mine's my, I just don't always just do it like super quick.
But look, cause see how perfect that thing is?
That's perfect.
And look at that. Like I said, it's not a huge profile. And especially for some of those finicky bass, that's perfect right there. We just worked back in this creek. We just got out here on the river. That was our first fish today. We tried at the mouth to start off with. We didn't have any bites. And right now, as we're easing into this fall pattern, the bass are chewing up on bait fish. And so we're really gonna hone in on these chatterbaits, crankbaits. What we're looking for is some of this cover. We have the tide that's going down right now. And what happens when this tide goes down, these bass suck tighter to the cover. So they're gonna be more predictable. When the tide's high, they're gonna be roaming a little bit more. It's gonna be harder to catch them. But when the tide drops, the cover's gonna come out of the water a little bit. It's gonna get shallower, and those bass are gonna tuck up tighter to the cover. So what we're looking at is just some of these laydowns that are coming by. Also some of these cypress trees. That cypress tree right there is actually exactly where I caught that fish. And what I did is I threw this chatterbait up there. I let it sink for a second. I started reeling it in very slow, and I was knocking this thing off the cypress knees on the bottom. Mm-hmm. That was a key to that bite. So
What we're gonna do is we're gonna work our way back in here. I think once we get in the back, there's gonna be a lot of fish, but I think we're gonna catch them really good. And once we fish this whole creek, we're gonna figure out where these fish positioned, then we're gonna duplicate that in some other lakes. So
let's get back to it.
I think that's a little finesse profile chatterbait going.
Be a danger to society. I got a big profile chatterbait.
I just feel. Yep.
Good one. That.
Oh no 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 no.
That was it.
I was just about to say, dude, they're gonna munch this right there, and he. Did you see him?
Yeah,
he's about 2.5, maybe three. High two. That was a good fish.
Like a three.
God, dog. He was right there where he should have been. I let this chatterbait sink. This was just a couple cast after that last fish. That was a good one, too. Mm. By the way, there's a tournament going out today, and we talked to some guys, and they said they caught a few. I don't know what that means. But we haven't been fishing for long, and I think they're going to eat the moving baits just because of this transition in this fall pattern. Those guys were throwing, you okay. Notice what they were throwing? They're throwing bottom baits. I think these fish want to react.
Oh, that was bad. It's almost ready for it to be full blown, like crankbait home, rigged up on the boat.
God, dog.
Oh, pick raw.
Dude, hammered it. Hammered that thing. I thought I had a big one. God, he spit it. Yeah, he spit it. Oh man, that was a good bite. That's where Katie actually hooked like a 8+, dude.
Really?
That scared me, yeah. Oh, that was a good bite. I thought it was a good bass, I really did.
I caught a big pike too.
Kind of feels good. It's got a little extra moderate to it.
You got any fish?
Oh, good night.
Off a backlash. I let it sink, dude.
Hi, Mr. Pescatelli's showing us how to kick bass today.
That was kind of crazy, dude. I haven't backlashed in a long time, and that was, like, amazing.
So you're kicking bass today?
I'll backlash every once in a while if I can catch a fish like that. I'm kicking bass right now, man. I'm trying to kick bass. Kicking pickerel. We had us a good one earlier.
That's a chunk.
A chunky guy, though. It's a beautiful one. Pretty markings. Gotta love those river bass, man.
Still nothing to put in the box.
Today, too. Pretty fish, man.
We're gonna put it back.
Yeah. A little fatty. We need us a bacon. I missed a good one. I missed that one that was like 2.5. That was a solid river fish, but we'll find some more. I think we're going to catch a big one back in this pocket.
We could have easily caught 11, I feel like.
Oh, that was almost beautiful, guys.
Oh.
Oh my goodness, guys, look at that spectacular bass. And
I don't know, that's not that big. You have a small fluke on, don't you?
Yeah,
Bradley, look, he's got a, that should be fun. It might be the chartreuse. Look how he ate it though. Well guys, they're munching this chatterbait. I can't get them off of it. Look at that, Bradley.
He ate
that's
that.
How you know. Yeah, the other ones haven't been eating it, but this one, I can tell you, this is a different story. We're in the back of this creek right now where we thought we were gonna get bit, and got us a little fat guy. Not bad. Can't complain. Let's see if we can get us another one back in here. I believe there's more fish. Oh my gosh. Dude, that's a big one. Is it a mudfish? He said, I got a fish. Is it a mud? Yeah, don't bring that.
Catfish?
As a mud. Don't bring it in the boat. He'd choke that too. Oh my God. You had him all the way back there, didn't you?
Were you like dragging over?
He's like, I got a fish, and I saw some big jump. I'm like, holy cow. That's where I caught him right there, 9-pounder. He's a high 8. He looked like a 9-pounder, though. Big. He was big, dude. Caught him right here on a floating worm. The funny thing about that fish, it was a week after my PB. I was on a roll, dog. then I went to the next lake we're going to, and I caught a 7 on a frog, and that was all within like 2 weeks, dude.
I'm hung up on fishing line. Look.
Is it? Dang it, Brad.
Bro, that's not me.
Dang it, Brad.
Wait, you know this happens to me.
Come
every
on,
time.
Brad.
Can't help that.
Get ready for Brad. Hey, Garrett. Just gonna give him a little tap on his.
Bro, if I went in the water, y'all talk about a video.
This is gonna do it. I'm gonna catch me a giant mud. Whoa.
Bro, it's throwing my booty sheet.
It's a line. Watch out for them big logs out here.
All right, guys, you got.
There he is. That's a bass.
Holy.
First cast.
That's oh, a... got one.
Nuh-uh.
Nope. I missed him.
What? You missed him?
Yeah, oh. Right on the edge of the current break. I was worried about smacking Garrett in the face because I looked back.
That's pretty fish.
That was him.
I didn't think he was a bass. Especially when I leaned into him, he felt big. They're moving out on this flat. This is crazy. Look at that one, Brad.
Pretty good.
That was nice. Literally first cast on the crawl, just.
Oh, wow.
Dude, that's big. Oh, what is that?
What it's is huge.
It? Dude, it's huge, whatever it is.
Donkey.
Dude, this is one of my biggest.
Oh, holy cow. Probably.
You think that's my biggest?
I don't know.
No, that's not my biggest. That's a big one though.
It's big for tattle.
Look at that, yeah. Look at that fish. Dude, that's insane.
All right. Nah, it's fine. Oh! Dang, baby. That's a river monster.
Bro, we should have fished right here with the line.
Look how fat this thing is. Look at this. These things are so annoying, bro. What I was going to say about your video, you do this, Bradley, mm-hmm. and it will be your last regret of your life if it ends up happening.
Wrapping my
when
hand around.
You wrap your hand around the line when you grip those muds, mm-hmm. what's gonna happen when that thing takes off? It's gonna cut all your fingers off, homie.
You remember that day you broke 50 pounds?
I know. That 50 pound mono,
How did that happen?
It's called, God was watching over me, man. One of those, we flopped them in the net. It jumped in the bottom of the boat, 50 pound fluorocarbon wrapped around my index finger. And it just randomly snapped. Mm. 50 pound. Yeah, dude, it was scary. I told Bradley, I was like, he's got my finger. Like, I thought it was coming off. Oh, at the top? What happened?
That was that fish that looked giant, but he kept him about.
Was it?
Mm-hmm. I want a picture on the front.
I got one. Yeah, dude. It's a good one, too. I barely hooks at him.
There we go, guys. Beautiful fish. Look at that. Chatter donk. Still eating it. Slowed down a little bit, but got us one. We're working back in this little cove. I've caught a ton of great fish back here. So, pretty little guy. Keep on covering water. I think the big ones are going to be in the back. 2 years ago, or actually a year and a half ago, caught one that was almost 8 pounds in the back of this place. So, I'm hoping we can get on one like that.
Oh, there he is. Dude, that. Oh my gosh, that was a giant fish.
Ooh, what's that smoke? Here he is.
Get him. Dude, that was such a big fish. Get him. That fish was huge.
Did you see
that? Where did you get that stroker crawl? I want one of them. I thought I was out of them.
I got my own secret stash.
Hold up, man. What are you trying to hide out from? Hey, that fish right there? It wasn't
that,
a mud.
That one that thumped me was best.
That thing was at least 4 pounds. I'm telling you. When I leaned up, it didn't move. Look at this stroker crawl. That's Junebug Red.
All right, boys and girls, we're getting ready to smack down on some of the world's hottest chips. Are you excited about it, man?
Are they the world's hottest
chips? I'm kind of excited about it. It is a world's hottest chip, right? Maybe?
Yeah, I think it is.
Apparently.
It definitely is. I don't know. I have to do some Google, but they say it's hot. I don't know. I don't know if it's really that hot. We're going to find out. So let's go ahead and munch into these things. Hottest chip right here. Got intern Brad, the hottest chip. Got Garrett right here.
Oh, whoa. Let's do a little unboxing.
All right.
What? Whoa, it's in its own package?
Dude, this is kind of crazy. Yeah, it's in its own package, and then what does that say? Oh, there's rounds.
It's got its own paperwork. Real heat.
Bro, I like this. By the way, I paid $30 for 3 of these things. Or no, I paid...
Get a free bag of this stuff. Oh, you get a free bag of the ghost pepper? Oh, okay. Might have to take them off on that, right?
Well, they got all the flavors on the bag.
So what they got? They got super hot, freaking hot, hot, kind of hot, not hot. Oh.
Yeah, we got water. Look all around.
Wait, is it going to last that long?
Yeah.
Are we going to make it off the lake?
Nah, bro. We're going to have to be hitting the bathroom after this.
It's a little packaging that it comes in. I'm actually really hungry. Oh, it's black.
Jerky.
I thought you were talking about just the outside.
No, it's black. It's like jerky.
Don't eat it yet. Are we eating it in one bite?
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
What do you think, in one bite?
I don't know if I can one bite that.
All right. Here's the chip. As you guys can tell, it's got like a black, weirded, I don't know. It's got like a bunch of thick, weird stuff on it. It almost looks burnt, to be honest with you.
I don't even know what to think.
You just gonna one bite it? I have two bites, by the way.
Do I need to break mine in half?
Another piece.
For a one biter?
I got some crumbs in my bag.
I might eat it in two bites.
No, are you chickening out? Oh, not at all. It's hot. Oh, look at my nose. Oh, God. It's stale.
Oh. Oh. I gotta eat the crumbs, dude. Oh. No, it's...
Oh.
It's mental.
I need some water, Coach.
I do, too.
Look at your feet. Look at your feet.
Here, Brad. Oh my God, that's hot.
I'm crying.
I have tears rolling down my eyes.
I might throw up. It's hot.
I got it in my eye.
Oh,
bro, it's hot.
It is the hottest.
I didn't even click record. My phone.
I'm not okay.
This is not good, bro.
Ah!
It's in my eye too. How's this man pissing right now?
Oh, my man's on fire!
Stop that, man.
It's not that bad. Are you crazy?
It's just like in my eye, bro. On my right hand side.
Guys, this is me after like, I'm crying. I can't. I can't do this. I lost the challenge. I don't even care. I was the first one to get water, and now everyone's crying. But I feel a little bit better.
It's bad, bro.
My mouth is still burning. Like tears are crying. I'm like crying. I don't even know if I want to post this.
All right, boys and girls, we are 5 minutes in. I don't know if you can tell, my eye's a little red. I got some in my eye like an idiot. I can feel it in the top. I wiped my hands all over my eyes. Very stupid. And I'm not gonna lie, I didn't think this was gonna be hot. He didn't either. But let me tell you, I can handle some of the, like, Buffalo Wild Wings. I eat their blazing sauce all the time. They run challenges with that. I don't have a problem with it. And that's Carolina Reaper blazing sauce. Something on that chip.
He's got your number, bro.
Oh, it's bad.
I'm dying.
Damn.
I'm not okay.
Let me just show you Brad. What's up, Brad?
Bro, I'm crying. Snot's running down my nose. Like, I knew when I bit the chip and it hit my throat and I felt an instant wave of just heat and like chill and like sweats going through me. I knew I'd have messed up.
What you think?
All the muscles in my face are just... going crazy. It was the saliva glands. Oh my God.
My stomach's starting to feel it now for the most part. I'm fine, but I will tell you, I've never ate anything to where tears started running down my eyes for no reason. You know? Like they were just dripping, bro. And I'm like, then I was like, whoa. So I rubbed my eye and that's where I messed up.
That pepper didn't make me run like that. It made me
Did
tear up.
Did you see mine? It teared up, bro. Like in the first 30 seconds, I was tearing up. That was not good. That was a lot hotter. That's the hottest thing I've ever had. That's hotter than Buffalo Wild Wings blazing sauce. It's not even close to that.
Let's get a hold of one.
I've had Wild Wings Cafe Braveheart, which is their hottest sauce, and I had that one when I was younger. It made me cry, but I went and had it last month, and it wasn't as bad.
You want to get a hold of one of them peppers in that jar, bro?
Not right now. That's bad, bro. My whole lips are feeling weird.
all feel good.
My arms are
Yeah, we ain't fishing the rest of the day. I want you to know that. Good thing we did it now. You're trying to get me to eat one of them peppers before I drove 2 hours home. You crazy. Dude, I would have been so miserable. Over here crying like a little girl.
That's what I am.